All right, let's talk about the TCP/IP model. And specifically, I want to talk about the five-layer TCP/IP model, because the five-layer TCP/IP model has those same numbers at the bottom. Remember in the other models video, I talked about layer one, layer two, layer three, and how often we talk about those layers. Well, the five-layer model has those same numbers at the bottom, so that's what I'm going to talk about today in this video. As far as what you can expect to learn and know by the end of this video, if you pay super close attention to remember everything or watch it a couple times until you learn everything you need to know. First of all, what are the names of the layers? Remember those. We talked about them in the layers video, but this is going to talk a little bit more in depth, a little bit more in detail about each of the layers and what they do. And also, what's the purpose of each layer? So each of these layers has a different role to play in the network. So what do they do? Why do we have all these layers, and what is the purpose and goals at each layer? And I'm going to tie it in with things that you've heard, maybe words you've heard as we've talked about networking, or as you've heard about networking, protocols that you've heard about for sure. So just be ready for all of that. So remember, this is the five-layer TCP/IP model. There's the four-layer model where the data link and the physical layers are combined into one, and that's called the data access or network access layer, something along those lines. But here we've got at the bottom we got the physical layer, the data link, the internet, the transport, and the application layer. And why do we have all of these layers? Why do we have this architecture? It's because different things happen at each layer, and each layer has a role to play as data moves across a network, and so you need to be able to think of it in this way. And so as data is being sent across a network, it starts at the application layer, and then moves down to the transport layer, down to the internet layer, down to the data link layer, and then finally down to the physical layer where it's bits and bytes and boops and moves across the network to the next spot hop along the path. That's what that is, and it comes down to the concept of encapsulation. And encapsulation is essentially putting envelopes inside of more envelopes. And at the top, you've got the application layer, and that's the data that you're writing on a letter. And then the letter gets put inside an envelope at the transport layer, and then the transport layer envelope gets put inside a network layer envelope, and then a network layer envelope gets put inside a data link layer envelope down the stack as you move down. And then as it gets to the other side and gets to where it's going, then it moves up the stack again. And each envelope is opened as you move up the stack. So that's kind of where this concept of encapsulation and how these layers all make sense in a way, because each of them has specific bits of information and a specific role to play, and each of them has its own addresses, which is helpful for this envelopes analogy. So as you go down, you start at the application layer, again, you move down, move into bits and bytes as you move across the network, ones and zeros, boop, 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 and it gets across, and then each of those goes back up on the other end. We'll talk more about that later, so don't stress too much. At the very bottom layer, we're gonna start at the bottom here, we have the physical layer, and the physical layer again is concerned with the bits and bytes, the ones, the zeros, the physical connections, the way that ones and zeros are moved across the world. So as you think about the physical layer, think about, I mean, there's all sorts of stuff. So there's radio waves, there's Wi-Fi, there's Ethernet cables and wires, and there's USB as a physical protocol as well. And each of those is concerned with just getting those ones and zeros, usually through some sort of modulation of voltage or modulation of frequency. And those are getting those ones and zeros from one place to another. And that is what the physical layer is really providing on the network. So the physical layer responsibility, again, is to get ones and zeros from one device to another. That's all the physical layer really cares about, is how do I get the ones and zeros that I have on my end across a wire, across the internet, across the airwaves, across whatever, so that you can have them on your end. And that can be through sound, that can be through electricity, that can be through light, that can be through radio waves, that could be through microwaves, that could be through, well, radio waves to satellites, that's the same kind of thing. Really, anyway, you could do it through smoke signals if you want to. All different ways that you can get ones and zeros from one device to another. So then we move up a little bit to the data link layer where we have local networks. And local networks meaning devices that are almost directly connected to each other. You're not going across the internet. You're not connecting to a computer in Taiwan using a local network. That's going through all sorts of other stuff. You're talking about computers that are wired together or connected via Wi-Fi on the same Wi-Fi network. Those devices are operating, and those kinds of networks can operate at the data link layer. And so what we're talking about here is direct communication between devices. Computers that are sending messages directly to the destination without having to go through a whole bunch of wibbly-wobbly, timey-wimey routers and all that stuff. Just direct connections. I am on the same network with the destination computer, the server that I'm sending it to. I don't need to get IP addresses involved. I can just send that message directly to the computer that I'm sending it to. And we'll get into more details later, but just remember that the data link layer is really concerned about the local network, your local connection to other devices nearby. Responsibilities for the data link layer include media access control. So all of these layers kind of deal with the layers above and below them. So the data link layer is concerned with accessing the physical layer. And that's this media access control. You'll hear that term. And remember that what that means is the data link layer is managing access to the medium or radio frequencies, Ethernet, wires, whatever the medium is that the physical network is operating at. It also manages error detection, because if it didn't, then errors would go all over the place. So the data link layer is responsible for listening for errors, detecting those errors, not necessarily doing anything about them, not necessarily correcting the errors, but detecting that the errors happen so that it can not just keep sending those errors out all over the place. So media access control, error detection, and then hardware addressing as well. So the physical address of your device, the MAC address, the media access control address, is a data link layer thing. Again, talk about all these in details later, but because we're talking about a local network, each of your devices has its own hardware address, and the data link layer is responsible for managing that. So protocols you've probably heard of at the data link layer, Ethernet is a big one. And that is a specific protocol that has specific rules about how media access happens and how data is transmitted. The Wi-Fi is another, probably even more popular one. 802.11n, 802.11ac, what are we at? AX now, AZ, ZY, I don't know. The letters keep changing, and it changes faster and faster every year. But all of these are, all of the Wi-Fi protocols are data link layer protocols, managing access to the network. And also 4G and 5G have data link layer protocols associated with them that control how you access the cellular network. So all of those are protocols that work at the data link layer. And then we move up a little bit more to the network layer, the internet layer. You might hear me call it the network layer. You might hear me call it the internet layer. Both names work. So the internet layer is what makes the internet work. It's inter-network, so sending data between different networks and routing data between different networks. That is what the internet layer is for, and that's what makes everything about the internet possible, because we now have protocols that can do that, that can route traffic between different networks. It doesn't get much more complicated than that. That is the job of the internet layer, is to figure out how to get traffic from your computer here to a computer in Taiwan, or a computer in Google's data center in California, or wherever it is that you need to go. And so to do that, part of what's added there is logical addresses. Logical addresses like your IP address. That is an address that is assigned to your device, but it is not assigned specifically to your hardware. Your IP address changes all the time. Your MAC address, the physical address of your hardware, does not change unless you tell it to change. But your logical address, your IP address, changes all the time. It changes when you come to school. It changes when you go home. It might change multiple times when you're at home throughout the week or day or year, depending on how things work. So all of that is part of the internet or the network layer. And again, it just comes down to sending traffic between networks, getting traffic from one network to the next network to the next network to the next network across 1,000 different networks to get where it wants to go. Well, hopefully not 1,000, because 1,000 networks would take a really long time and be really complicated. You can get most places in the world with 20 to 40 networks. So 1,000 seems excessive. But sending traffic between networks is really the network layer's responsibility, or the internet layer's responsibility. Protocols, I'm sure you've heard of the internet protocol, IP. IPv4 and IPv6 are two different internet layer protocols, and they perform more or less the same responsibilities in perhaps different ways. So keeping in mind that encapsulation of responsibilities and separation of duties that these layers provide, we have two different protocols that do more or less the same or at least similar things, but operate very differently in the way that they accomplish their goals. There's also the Internet Control Message Protocol, or ICMP, and there's a bunch of others that we'll talk about later on to do with routing and finding paths across the network and things like that. But these ones are things you're gonna hear about a lot. ICMP is the protocol that contains something called a ping. So if you've ever pinged a server or pinged something, that's using the Internet Control Message Protocol. Next layer up, we have the transport layer. And the transport layer is where things start to get really cool. Basically, you have ports at the transport layer to connect to applications. And what does that mean? Again, more of this will come later, but transport layer is really the connection where you make the leap from connecting to a computer somewhere to a specific application on the computer somewhere. So it is the connection protocol between your IP address and the application that the reason we have computers and the reason we have networks is to do application-y things, not just to send packets back and forth, because that's not that fun. Applications are the fun part. So these ports you have seen don't look like these at all, but the concept is the same in that they are a spot that on your computer that something is listening. And so if you think of these ports of an electrical port as something that is sitting in your wall and it's listening and it's waiting for an electrical connection. And when you plug in a device, then it starts sending or streaming those electrons out to that device. And that is what's going on at the transport layer. So, but other responsibilities are also, it provides reliability if needed. So sometimes it's really, really important that every single packet get across the network. And sometimes it's really not that important that every single packet get across the network, and reliability can be dumped. But transport layer is the layer where you make that decision, choose your protocol depending on whether or not you need that reliability, and then you create a socket. And these here are the sockets that I'm talking about, where you have applications on a computer that are listening, that are waiting for a connection, for a message to be sent, and once that message is received and they're ready to transmit or do whatever it is they need to do. So a socket is a combination of, let me hop out of the way here. A socket address is a combination of the transport protocol, port number, and the IP address. This is a Wikipedia definition more or less. So you have an IP address and a port number and the protocol. So protocols that we need to talk about, the Transmission Control Protocol, or TCP, the TCP, this is the famous TCP from TCP IP. IP is the famous IP, the internet protocol that we talked about before, but we've got the Transmission Control Protocol, TCP, and the User Datagram Protocol, or UDP, and both of these protocols work, they do different things, we'll talk more about them later, don't worry so much about it. But if you take that transport protocol, again, TCP or UDP, and a port number, again, we'll talk about those more later, and an IP address, what you put those all together and you have a socket. And that is essentially a computer making a plug-in that other things can connect to in order to send and receive data, just like those sockets on the wall. Excellent. Finally, we have the application layer. And the application layer is where things get real, where things get important, really. This is why we have networks. Obviously, we don't set up networks just because we really love packets. We set up networks because we want to get things done, and applications are the way that we get things done. And There's a whole bunch of application layer protocols. We'll talk about some of them. You've heard of a bazillion of them. And we'll get really in depth on a few like HTTP or SMTP or SSH and really talk about what these protocols are and how they work. But all of these are sort of, I say the parts that you see-ish, because you don't necessarily see HTTP happening. You see the results of HTTP happening. When you send requests to a web server and get a response back, you're not looking at the HTTP get request that went out and the HTTP get response or the HTTP response that was sent back. You see the pretty website and the pictures and everything. And that's why I say ish, because it's right there. It's connected to the parts that you see. It's the things that you care about and what makes the things that you care about work. And all the protocols are important. Transport layer protocols are important. Internet layer protocols are important. But really, these are the kings. This is why networking exists. So you've got things like HTTP is a big one. Email and the protocols that make email work. BitTorrent has its protocols that make everything fit together and let you chop things up and send them across the network and download things from a million different devices at once. And it's really cool protocols. Every video game's got its own protocol. You've got all sorts of things. Dropbox has its own protocols. All of these things are part of those application layer protocols. And application layer responsibilities, really, it's to do cool stuff. It's to do the stuff that makes a network work so that we can do the stuff that we care about. And that's what the application layer is for. It's to set up the way, the instructions for getting data somewhere and getting data from somewhere. And that's about it. All of these protocols, HTTP, SMTP, the Dropbox LAN sync protocol, the Dropbox sync protocol. There's a million different application layer protocols. There's probably more than a million. A million is probably understating how many different application layer protocols there are that all do different things to make applications work on the internet. So remember, encapsulation. Things, data starts at the top, at the application layer. The really important stuff is at the top. That's the postcard that gets put inside an envelope, that gets put inside an envelope, that gets put inside an envelope, that gets turned into ones and zeros going across the network, that then gets recombined and put back together in that encapsulation. So a couple things to think about as you've listened, as you've learned, a way to check if you've really got what we're talking about here. What are the five layers? What are the five layers of the five-layer TCP/IP model? And what is the responsibility of the internet layer? If you've got a good answer, great. If you don't, maybe go back and look over things again. All of the layers are valuable. The internet layer is just the one I picked for this question, but it's worth thinking about what are the responsibilities at each layer. And that's it for the TCP/IP model.